So Burgener warm up, if you do it quickly, it should only take you about 30 seconds. So I'm gonna time this now. We're gonna go through the whole thing. We're gonna do 3 reps each. I'm gonna call out the movement. You're gonna yell back the callback. And then we're gonna try to finish this in a moderately quick pace, right? But we still want it to be pretty. So footwork, stand, last one, drop.
Footwork.
Stand. Okay, that was not too bad, 57 seconds.
We're supposed to do all that 30?
Huh?
We're supposed to do all that 30?
Yeah, it's totally doable. Here, let's try this. I'm gonna try it right now. Here we go. Ready, and speed to the middle. Keep the bar close, Strong turnover, Footwork, footwork. 16 seconds. Do you guys all have 16 seconds in your day? Right, in my gym, we have 2 rules. Okay, the first thing you do when you walk in the door is you do joint rotations. The second thing you gotta do is the Burgener warm-up and the skill transfer exercises. That will take you 47 seconds. The Burgener warm-up and the skill transfer exercises. Do y'all have 47 seconds? Guarantee you if you do that every single day, you're gonna get better at the snatch. Because fundamentals are king. If you have these parts down, I don't have to remind you armpits forward, all this stuff, then everything else becomes a whole lot easier. It's like driving stick. You guys drive stick? Who drives stick? Do you have to think about shifting into second gear when you turn left? No, you just do it. Same thing here. There's 90 million other things to worry about in the snatch. So if you can get these parts ironed out, it's gonna be a whole lot better for you. You guys agree? So there was a consequence. If my athletes didn't do the joint rotations and the Burgener warm-up, we would throw away the workout and do 12.1.